Hey Wastelanders, welcome back. In this episode, we're going to be clearing the area northwest of Sanctuary and then following the edge of the map down to the south until we get to Abernathy Farm. Once there, we'll pick up the quest to get the locket from the USAF satellite station Olivia and then work our way back towards Sanctuary. On the way towards Sanctuary, we'll clear out the mole rat den that's in the cave under Red Rocket, and at that point, we should be at least level 10, and we'll be ready to take on Concord and start exploring deeper south and east. As usual, I'll be trying to fast forward through the less interesting parts and pointing out areas that I think are more significant. So, with that said, let's get exploring. Okay, so back here, way back behind and to the east, sorry, to the west of Sanctuary, there's a little shack, and there's not a whole lot in here, but, you know, there's some heat adhesive and stuff. It might be worth coming back in the early game. Yes. I like to come back here at least. I just feel like I haven't done everything if I haven't come back here. You don't have to. By all means, feel free to skip this, and all the hub flowers and stuff on the way. They're not necessary. I just know that later on I'll be hurting very badly for hub flowers, so I like to get all of them that I can. Oh, those are settlers. Well, they're hostile now, I guess I'll just kill them. So there's a group of raiders that spawn over here, as well as a random event. Apparently this time the random event was settlers attacking these raiders, and apparently the settlers actually won pretty handily. Unfortunately, I did not realize that they were settlers, and I attacked them and killed them. At least they gave experience, I guess. And since they deprived me of killing the raiders, I'm just gonna kill this preacher as well, because hey, free experience. There is no karma in this game. Sorry, preacher. I just want to note, in the distance over there, you could see a building, and that is Wicked Shipping. You don't actually want to go down there quite yet, because you don't want the stuff to spawn there yet. I do believe that's a different cell over there. So save that for after Concord, after you've gotten a couple of levels, and yeah, just explore the area kind of around it, but don't actually walk into Wicked Shipping itself. So over here on the very edge of the map, you'll find a trader that trades some junk. If you're very lucky, he might have something that has crystals in it, like a camera or a crystal liquid decanter. And if he does, or she does, then you can create a settlement recruitment beacon early on. Before you even get the Minutemen, you can have settlers at your sanctuary settlement. Of course, you want to put on your fancy charisma gear.
Hey.
And steal a guy's corn first.
Let's trade.
And see what they have to trade. In this case, I was unlucky. They didn't have much. Squirrel bits are always useful, though, so I bought those and a couple other things. And there's actually a shack that they kind of live in, and if you sneak in there, you can pretty easily steal everything. Even with one agility and no sneak skill, it's quite easy to rob everything from them, which is kind of mean, but hey, there's no karma in this game, and we want everything we can get, so why not? When you get over here to Abernathy Farm, make sure you pick up all of these potatoes. We're going to use those as our starter crops for Sanctuary to provide food for our settlers, and it'll be useful later whenever we're making adhesive. It's one of the main ingredients. So otherwise, you want to find mute fruit and corn. Unfortunately, there is none here at Abernathy, so you're probably going to have an excess of potatoes and not enough corn and mute fruit. But you will find some eventually, and then you'll be able to start making adhesive.
Excuse me.
That's close enough, stranger.
It's okay, I'm friendly. Not looking to...
If you say so, let me...
Farming's hard work.
Won't I, Blake Apple?
Uh-huh. I'm...
Good to see you. How about...
I'm sure I'll give it a try someday.
Well, maybe...
Sure.
Word of advice, though. Why do...
Sounds like bad news to me.
You... Last time... Now she's buried up. That's why we...
There's nothing worse than losing it.
I don't know if you could get...
Don't worry. I'll get that...
Good.
Okay, so we've got the quest to go over to USAF Satellite Station Olivia. You don't actually have to pick up the quest to get the locket. You can bring it back later without having the quest. You can just go there and clear it out, and you'll find it, and you'll be able to bring it back here to turn it in. But why not? We're over here. Might as well. So over here by this water tower, you'll find a first aid kit that has some chems in it for you, stim pack and some stuff, as well as some purified water. Now, if you look at this water tower, and you can see the words conquered, and you kind of go straight back from it, you will find a chest, and right here it is, a steamer trunk. That is a boss level chest. It's fairly empty because we're low level, but it does have some pretty good loot. So make sure you pick that up on your way. Right there is where it is on the map, so you have it for reference. And now we're going to head back to Red Rocket and clear out the Mole Rat Cave. And since it's night already, we'll probably go back and sleep. Hopefully we get a level up before then. And on the next day, we're going to go and clear out Concord. So of all the loot in here, the one thing you really want to make sure you don't miss is this fusion core, right by this old reactor. You'll take some rads walking over here, but it's well worth it. Alright, so here we are back at Sanctuary. It's nighttime. We're gonna do some inventory management stuff, craft some chems, cook some meat, check our workshop for water, and then probably go to bed. And then we'll take care of Concord whenever we wake up in the next day. Well, it's time once again to level up, and we did manage to get to level 10. So here's a quick recap of the perks we've gotten so far. Idiot Savant at 2, Scrounger at 3, Science at 4, Locksmith at 5, 6 we save for level 7, 7 is Scrounger rank 2 and Locksmith rank 2, 8 is Lone Wanderer, 9 is Chemist, and 10 is Gun Nut. So with level 10, we are able to make a very nice pipe rifle, which we will be crafting in a little bit. Now at this point I'm just doing some chem and other crafting, just prepare for Concord tomorrow whenever we're ready to do it. So I want to make sure we have as much experience as we can possibly get beforehand, so I'm just making anything I can that I think is worthwhile. Any healing stuff, antibiotics, cutting fluid as well, that's basically oil. Drugs, you want to make buff tats, psycho buff, psycho jet, overdrive, any jet that you can make, grape mentats, all that kind of stuff. So just crafting that stuff, and then we'll go to bed and we'll be ready for Concord tomorrow. Okay, so it's a new day. We're just gonna craft some food that I forgot to craft the previous day. Do not craft your squirrel into Crispy Squirrel. Be careful about that. It's very easy to do. Squirrel bits are pretty rare, and you want to save those for making squirrel stew because it is a 2% experience bonus. So it's not huge, but I mean 2% is 2%, so you might as well. Alright, so I'm just coming back from doing a little bit of building. Decided to kind of mess with the roof on top of my settler's quarters. Unfortunately, I ran out of glass, and I was making prefab barn kind of roof wall type things, I guess is what they're called. And I ran out of glass, which means I can't continue to make them. There's no alternative that doesn't use glass, so basically I need more glass for when I continue making it like that. I also made a kind of gatehouse at the front, just because I felt like doing it. At this point, I'm gearing up to go into Concord. So I've got my mini nuke, I've got 3 fusion cores, I've got all of my 38 rounds, which I've been saving up, and I'm about ready to craft a nice pipe rifle here that we'll use to take into Concord and kick some butt, use up those 38 rounds. So for this pipe pistol, we're going to make it into a pipe rifle using the highest one we can go. That's the powerful receiver. Ideally later on we're going to use the powerful automatic receiver, the long finned barrel and all that, but right now this is the best we can make, is the long ported barrel with the powerful receiver. Just go as high as you can on this stuff, you know, make it as good as you can. The biggest upgrades are probably going to be the big mag, make sure you have a reflex or a glow reflex sight, that'll make it a lot easier to aim. Muzzle brake reduces the recoil a whole bunch, you know, standard stuff. And later on we'll get a comfort grip just to make it a little bit more easy to use. Not ideal, we'd like to have a bigger stock on it, but we just don't have materials right now. So we did get a level up here, and for this level we're going to put our point into Nuclear Physicist to increase the amount of time we get out of our fusion cores. Okay, so I skipped ahead a little bit here, just did some inventory management stuff. We're going to suit up and head out into Concord, so we're going to make sure we have the correct armor and the correct weapons and everything. Going to dump our charisma gear for now because we need the carry weight, we're not going to use it. Make sure we put on that helmet. And we're gonna head in. So I will see you once we're in Concord again. And this is the little gatehouse type thing I built. So it's alright. I wanted something like this and I don't know, it looks okay. Got me some experience, so not too troubled about it.
Up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
Die on me! sweet.
Got it.
Just get the hell out of here. We got no reason to hang around.
Get some! Kill him!
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minuteman.
Glad to help.
Please, go on.
Sorry. Sounds rough. One good idea can make all the difference.
Nope.
I had a whole fancy plan about fixing up a suit of power armor. And here you are, walking in like some kind of metal miracle. There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school. Pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, it's got a minigun, and it seems to be intact. Wearing that armor, you could rip it right off. Then those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Can't be too hard. I'll see what I can do.
Well, all right.
Excellent.
Careful.
Angry.
There are more of you. Right?
Here. Boss, we got somebody up here.
Got this. Keep your cool.
Why don't you get down here? Show me that fancy gun. That's my boys. I'll give you that. You're waiting, asshole.
There you are.
Got something over here. I knew it.
Well, that was a giant whiff. Oh well, it's a thought that counts. Usually I can hit him, but he just decided to run after a raider over there, so guess we'll take him out with a minigun. No big deal. So, I actually made a mistake here. I should have gotten Idiot Savant at level 11 and being at level 12 instead. So that kind of sucks. I could have gotten some extra experience there, but no big deal. It is correct if you look at it in the guide. So I'm just trying to decide here what chems to use, and I think I assigned my chems as well to specific hotkeys so I can use them without having to go to my inventory every single time. Highly recommend you do this for survival. Make the gameplay a lot smoother and a lot quicker. I think I do end up using Overdrive and Psychojet. And that, folks, is how you take out a Deathclaw with ease. You use drugs. Drugs solve everything, at least in Fallout 4. So just some looting to take care of here, and then we'll head inside, talk to Preston, and send the Minutemen on their way over to Sanctuary.
Pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
You guys gonna be okay now?
Yeah, for a while anyway. We can at least move some. Listen, when we first met, you said you were glad to help. Well, you did. And we owe you our lives. So here, it ain't much, but it's the best way I can say thank you.
What happens now?
For the longest time, Mama Murphy's had a vision of a place called Sanctuary. Why don't you come?
All right, Garvey. I'm in.
Oh.
My destiny? What do you mean?
You're a man.
Bullshit. You're trying to play me for a fool.
Oh, no, kid. No. The sight's sometimes foggy, but it ain't ever a liar. Your son, and even the...
That's...
Look.
Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk is gonna kill you.
Oh, shush, Preston. We're all gonna die of it. And Joel, we're gonna need the sight. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too. Let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy saw it?
It can hardly turn out any worse than.
Everybody just take it easy. We're all in this together, right? So Marcy, got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody? Well then, Sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June, it's time to go.
Oh, okay.
So at this point I realize there's this fat man here that I want to take back, but it weighs too much. You can definitely do this on survival mode. Just hold E to pick it up and literally just carry it with you the whole way back. I've done it multiple times with various heavy weapons like missiles, or even just missiles as ammo, because missiles weigh a ton. They're 7 units each on survival. And if you get a stack of like 30 of them, from looting a town or something, then that can easily take up your entire inventory weight limit. So better to just dump them all on the ground, hold E to pick them up, and carry them with you wherever you want to go. Yep, that looks like a good spot for it. Okay, so we're getting near the 50-minute mark. I'll probably go ahead and end the video here, and do my inventory management and stuff, maybe talk to Preston and Sturgis off screen to get their quests, and then we'll continue exploring the wastelands in episode number 3. Thanks again for watching. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe. I really appreciate it.